So I just do it on my tension tools. Here we go. Well, that was a little easier than I thought it was going to be. That's a picked Ruko 600 gins. Quick photo op. Alright, well, I can cut this one easy enough. And I want to show it's got gins, so double time, right? Had a little fun with some googly eyes. I don't want to damage it. It's not my lock, so I try to. See that? No scuff marks. I like it like that. No scuffers.
problem, buddy.
Tap enough pins out. You figured I'd be good. See the counter milling in there. Can bend my pick on it. And then, like, what did I just do? There we go. Right in front of me. So, I was trying to preset as many as I could. Another gen coming out. So, I would feel the gen pass the top lip and go to the relief. And rather than keeping tension hard and like trying to get the core to turn, I'd leave the tension right about where it was and try to get it to go up one more little click. And if you can get it to go up that extra little click, then you generally will borderline overset it. And in the process, when you go to the next pin, take your pick pressure off, it should drop down. And if you work out binding order somewhat, then it shouldn't actually fall. I just shot that over there. Pull the tweezers right out of my hands with these. Catch very, very well. Well, if you stayed this long, I appreciate you. Nice, quick Ruko 600 Gins pick and gut. tools was just flat, deep jimmy hook. Fatty pry bar. Well, thanks for watching. Cheers, everyone. Have a great day. Later.